Episode 377. The pursuit of success can be a catalyst for failure. Greg McKeown. Welcome back, Quest for You, friends. I want to talk about food today. Not specific kinds of food. Not a diet plan. Not any medical advice. Simply the topic of food. I have touched on it a few times in older episodes. I don't talk about it a lot, mostly because I'm not qualified to give you nutritional advice, but also because there is not so much to talk about. The title of this episode tells you why. Simplify your nutrition. If you're out there looking for help or advice on your diet, if you're trying to eat better, healthier, cleaner, if you're looking to lose weight, become stronger and fitter, trying to avoid certain foods such as gluten or meat, whatever your goal is, maybe your resolution for this year, this one small advice is the best advice I can give you in regards to your nutrition. And I'm able to do so after years of experimenting with food. I never had any issues with food, not any specific allergies or reactions, no health issues like problems with the gut that many people have. I didn't have any weight issues really either. I always ate pretty healthy because I grew up with healthy, home-cooked food. As you learned on last week's episodes, my grandmother had a huge garden and grew many of her own vegetables and herbs. Every dinner was accompanied by a fresh salad. Every meal contained vegetables. And that is probably why to this day I still love vegetables and always include them in my own meals. Not having grown up with fast food, I never craved it. An occasional trip to a fast food place was a treat just like any other restaurant. That was before I knew anything about nutrition. I questioned my food for the first time after college, when my first job involved sitting all day, something I wasn't used to. I lived close to campus and I walked a lot. I worked 3 jobs and was always on my feet. And I didn't have much money, so I didn't afford myself any tempting treats. I prepped all my own meals, the way I did it back in Germany. Many of the American foods that are sugar and starch loaded and line the majority of the grocery store shelves never interested me. But when I started working in an office, my movement slowed down dramatically. And, in addition, there was suddenly more food around, as in every office. And I wasn't used to free food. With the poor college student mindset, I loaded up every time I had a chance, whatever there was, even if they were cupcakes. And slowly I started seeing my pant size go up. I still clearly remember the day I decided I needed a change. I was at a conference in Miami, and one of those days I went shopping. I was at a Banana Republic outlet looking for work pants and had to try on size 10. Size 10. I was always a 6. This was when I became concerned, and my life changed. I still lived with my college roommate at the time that I started working. He was a runner from South Africa. As soon as I returned from that business trip, I started running. Running was the first solution that came to my mind because of my roommate. And I also looked closer at my food. Since he ran for the university, he also gave me some nutritional advice. And this is now a long time ago. And since I started running, I have never been a size 10 again. I returned to my size 6 with some fluctuations up and down over the years. But fitness and nutrition became a major part of my life. Over the years, and especially when I couldn't run anymore, I tried many forms of exercise and experimented with a lot of diets. And I've learned a lot. But I can tell you this. Most of what I learned is very specific to me and my body. I tried what everyone said is good, and not all of it makes me feel good. Coffee, for example, has many benefits, but I can't handle drinking it regularly. And not everything that everyone says is bad is actually bad for me. Gluten, for example. I don't have any issues with it and feel just fine when I eat it. That is the reason I would never feel comfortable telling people what to eat, because everyone is different. Our bodies handle food differently, depending on our parents, our upbringing, and our internal makeup. But I can tell you this. When you simplify your diet, you will accomplish all your other goals around food. A simpler diet takes less time to prepare. There's less figuring out to do. What can I eat and how much? It forces you to plan better, which is a valuable skill. It teaches you discipline, but also self-reliance. You don't need to read long ingredient lists on labels or ask restaurants for details on how their food is prepared. When others spend hours in the store deciding what to buy, you already know what you need. It saves time and energy wasted on making decisions. Simplifying your nutrition means three things to me. 1. Simpler foods. Simple foods are as close to its original state as possible. Fruits, veggies, meat, fish, eggs, nuts, and they are minimally prepared, which means you can still identify them and taste them after cooking them. This doesn't mean I don't eat packaged foods, but I keep them minimal. They make up a small percentage of my diet, and I choose those with simple ingredients. Again, ingredients I can identify. A great example are bars. Granola bars, protein bars, energy bars. Grocery stores have added entire aisles to make room for bars. Next time you place them in your cart, look at the ingredient list. I eat only one, maybe two kind of protein bars, and I know what all the ingredients are. Most of them I can spell and know. The couple that I didn't know, I looked up and researched. But I will not research foods with 5 or more unpronounceable ingredients. These are not simple foods. 80% of my meals are home-cooked with minimal additions to change them. We make our nutrition so complicated. It's tempting. I get it. The internet is full of amazing recipes. Restaurants constantly invent new ways to make foods such as Brussels sprouts attractive. But if I get them and cannot even identify them as Brussels sprouts because they are now brown and soaked in some form of liquid and covered with bacon, then what is the point? Simpler foods will make your life easier, my friends. Others may call it boring when you order the chicken and rice yet again, but I call it control. I am in control of what I eat, and I don't have to feel bad about it. 2, fewer foods. When you start buying simpler foods, you'll notice that 95% of the grocery store doesn't apply to your needs anymore. You have fewer options now, and that's a good thing. Too many choices only lead to bad decisions. Trying to figure out which coconut milk will fit the low-fat category on your list? Skip it altogether and stick with the simple concept. This will have the added benefit that the occasional meal out or the potluck with your friends will be more appreciated and tastes better. You hear me talk a lot about distractions. Food is one of them. We spend so much time deciding on food. Which bar is healthier? Which restaurant to go eat at? Which recipe to use? All this goes away when you have your list of items and stick to them. What they are depends on your dietary requirements, your cultural background, and your goals. Wherever you live in this world, you can use the concept of simplified nutrition. It may take some experimenting on these few staples that make up the core of your diet, but you may already know what they are. These are the foods that you know your body likes and handles well. And lastly, 3 is regular foods. Eat them regularly. This will make the difference with any goals that you have, such as weight loss. Experimenting around with 10 different chicken recipes takes time, energy, and it makes it more complicated to track. I used to think I needed variety. I really don't. I look forward to my regular meals, which are often the same day in and day out. The more regular you eat, the quicker you can also analyze if something isn't working. Complex meals often complicate everything. It can take time to figure out which specific food causes indigestion or any other issues. The simpler you eat and the more regular, the easier it will be for you to eliminate foods that your body doesn't like. Regularity also helps if you're trying to change your diet. first, the body rebels. When I cut my calories, I'm always hungry for the first 2 to 3 days. I used to fiddle with this. Oh, I worked out today, so my body needs a snack. Not true. Remember, you decide. You have control. And after a few days of adjustment, the body learns and it's on board. Our quote from the beginning. The pursuit of success can be a catalyst for failure. This applies especially well to food. We try too hard. We experiment with all these different foods, diets, and recipes. And we never accomplish our weight loss and fitness goals. Keep it simple, my friends. It's my best advice. And try it for 4 to 8 weeks. Stay consistent. It may feel awkward and restricting at first, but I promise you, in the long run, it will give you confidence because you will see results. Much love.